Really?
You want to get your fucking juices flowing.
What happened?
Buster Douglas was like a could have been great heavyweight. That was like he would show up out of shape. He was kind of like a bum, but he was like he could have been great. Like mm-hmm. he was a monster, and he fought Tyson in his prime. He was the guy who beat Tyson first.
Okay.
And he was 42-1 odds. That's why it was called that. But they were like, every announcer was like, this isn't going to go past the first round. All that shit. In training, Buster Douglas's mom died like 2 weeks before. And then he won. He just fucked him up. Well, he didn't fuck him up. He got tagged, too. Mm-hmm. It was a great... I mean, it's an awesome
dude,
fight. I immediately
Tyson
watched the fight.
Was terrifying.
Yeah,
dude.
Well, Tyson apparently, you know, he didn't train as hard. He was like... It was supposed to be a tune-up fight. It was just a tune-up fight for...
He was Apollo.
Holyfield. Yeah. And then he got laid out. It's fucking sick. It was the first time anybody knocked him down.
Damn.
It was awesome. And then, you know, in the ring after, they're like, how do you feel? And he's like, this is for my mom. And I was just like...
He Rocky'd, basically. Yeah, man, that's
just got kind of hit hard with it. And Phil was like, "Where are you watching?" And I was like, "It's called 42-1." It was one of those. Had to hide it.
That's the only thing.
He was
you
like, "Buster Douglas, he's a bitch. He's tough." That was it.
He was probably crying. He was probably like crying, eating bologna. He'd be like, "Where are you watching? He's a bitch."
Yeah. He's like, "I'll tell you what, he's a bitch." He says that as a compliment.
Yeah, yeah.
Like tough. Fun. Speaking of a bitch, Tybalt.
What happened?
Tybalt's a bitch, dude.
What
My Tybalt? Cat.
What's he doing?
He's an apex predator, dude.
Did he get it?
So I was watching. No, but he went toe to toe with a fox. I was watching TV. It was like 12:30. Everyone's in bed. All of a sudden, I hear a scream from the backyard. This is two nights ago.
What?
Like screaming. And I was like, what the fuck is that? And I was like, oh, that's definitely a fox. Like, I could tell it was a fox. And I was like, oh shit, Tybalt's outside. So I got like nervous, grabbed a big flashlight, and I was like, I'm going to have to beat a fox to death. Like, I was mentally, I was shoeless, ran in the backyard. I was just like, I'm just going to have to beat a dog to death right now, which is a weird mind space to get in.
Yeah.
Like, it is a weird space to be walking out. Like I was adrenaline. I was like, here we go. But Tybalt was just staring him down, dude. Didn't care less.
The fox was
Couldn't care less. The fox was probably like 5 yards, 10 yards away, just like kind of moving back and forth, like screaming at him. And Tybalt was just sitting there like, what are you going to do, bro?
Fuck.
What are you going to do? So then I pick up Tybalt, and I'm like, like not running, but like walking fast, looking backwards. I don't want to get bit by a fox.
No, I'll nip your ankle, dude.
Yeah, it would suck. And then as soon as I put Tybalt down in the house, he just started eating. Didn't give a dude. I put him down. He walked straight to his food and started eating. I was like, dude, you are a monster.
Holy fuck.
He didn't care
at all.
That's
a fair fight, him versus a fox?
Yeah, he's big. He's got his claws. He's a mean little fucker.
That's a fair fight.
I've done it before. I've walked outside and he got fucked up before.
By what?
I don't know what it was. Probably a fox.
By a coyote.
Or a raccoon. Something big got him.
Raccoon will give him the business, dude.
Something fucked him up. Like, fucked his legs up. And he shit himself. When they're running away, cats will shit themselves. So I picked him up. He was covered in blood and shit. Yeah. But this time, not a scratch on him, dude. He literally just sat in the grass, stared at a fox. Couldn't have been prouder of my guy.
He's got to be terrifying at night, too. He's jet black. That fox probably just saw glowing eyes and was like, fuck, man.
That's the prince of cats, dude. That's a big night.
That's big, dude. So that was after 41 and 2?
Yeah. 42 and 1.
42 and 1?
There's a big couple of days. Phil had to do that once.
What?
Tybalt got in a fight in the front yard with another cat. So it was like, you know, 5, 6 in the morning. You just hear two cats screaming. Phil ran down in his whitey tighties. This is like 6 a.m. So people are like walking out to get the newspaper and shit. School buses. Oh. Phil was out in just his whitey tighties and a fishing rod. Swinging at the cats.
That was his weapon?
He grabbed a fishing rod from the closet that was right by the door and just started whipping cats. Yeah, man. It's a strong tradition in the Gillis family, too.
Cat whipping.
If your cat's in a fight, you got to jump in, dude.
Oh, my God.
I was ready to strangle a fox.
You have to, man. You got to.
That would have sucked.
We have a possum on the loose, and it's through a chain link fence, it stared down my dog.
I love possums.
They're fucking nasty,
No,
dude.
They're funny.
Ugh. They're disgusting.
They are. They're ugly, but I'm a fan.
They're hellish. I saw it skittering around the other day. I was walking home. Brittany called me, like, the possum's back in the backyard.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Do you have, like, a garden or anything?
No, it's just, but all there's right. like a ton of, there's like a little alley that links a bunch of yards, so it kind of just scoots around. But I saw,
it's
I parked
poss,
my car,
dude.
I saw that poss running across the street, and I was just like, ugh.
You didn't like him?
Nasty little
I'm a fan of him. Did I tell you what my roommate did to a possum?
What?
He murdered one.
Okay.
It was in his parents' garden.
Yeah.
But it turns out possums mostly help you.
Actually, speaking of the epidemic of fatness, Lemaire suffered a fat attack, dude, in public.
Oh, you bringing up Lemaire's fat attack? Yeah. Lemaire.
Lemaire said it wasn't a fat attack.
It is 100% a fat attack.
I'll give you the version.
Before we go any further, I will say this. High school football.
Yeah.
Every single year, a kid suffered from a fat attack. And it's the funniest thing in the world. No, you remember this? When the pussy kids on the team would be like, I'm having heat stroke. And they'd have to sit in the gator. They'd have to sit in the gator under the shade. Fat attacks on the football field.
Fat attacks are real.
And then occasionally dudes would die from fat attacks. Like every year across the country, a bunch of dudes die from fat attacks in practice. But every year, dude, one of them listens to this. One of my friends had a fat attack, and I know he listens to this. They taped ice across his chest, and he had to sit in the gator with his shirt off.
Yeah, you need – they're like EpiPens or
Nugs,
like defibrillators.
Dude. What up, Nugs?
Instead of the defibrillator, you need like a fan for a fat attack. You're just like, oh, hold on.
Fat attacks are brutal.
Blow some air. Turn it up. No, we need high. Turn it up to high, doctor.
So, Lemaire, you got sent to the gator, dude. They had to put you under a tree.
This was a story I heard. It was that the place was packed, right? So, already it's packed, summertime. The threat levels for a fat attack are high. So I said, Lemaire pulls up.
They should have that on the news. Like a weather channel be like, today's fat attack probability is red. We're in the red today. Might want to powder your balls, fats.
Powder your balls and keep a towel handy to dab your head.
If you're black, you can carry a towel, which is nice.
I saw a guy dabbing his head today.
If you're white, you must wear shorts and Crocs.
Yeah, so Lemaire, the story was you rolled up. It was sweltering. It was crowded. And then
showed up uninvited.
A good friend of the
correct
body.
Me if I'm wrong. Uninvited to
well,
a
no,
full
he was
capacity.
Warned. He was warned. Our friends were like, Lemaire, it's really crowded here and it's really hot. You can come, but it's going to be kind of miserable.
So his friends were like, there's a good chance you're going to have a fat attack. Yeah. I'm not going to say it, but it's hot up here. It's not built for the thicks.
Yeah.
The so fats.
You were discovered on the steps of this place. Am I correct? sitting, not laying.
Didn't make it to the roof.
No, I think he made it. He went back in.
You can make like a video game out of it, like an Oregon Trail. Just Lemaire trying to get to a rooftop.
It was hot.
You have to stop and hunt for chips. You have to dump, dude.
Dude, it gets even better. So the story I heard that you, I guess you went out there, like, oh, it's too crowded, hit the steps, and then you were discovered by a friend of the podcast sitting there.
Friend of the podcast found you.
She was like
collapsed in the hallway,
concerned, and was like, "Dude, are you okay?" And you were like, "I don't feel well." So then you went and
they gotta treat it. They gotta throw buckets of water on him. They gotta treat him like a whale being transported to a different tank. They gotta throw water on him.
Lemaire was then transported to the owner's bed, and laid in the owner's bed. Fans on. Did you have a cold towel? I believe there's a cold compress applied.
No.
Ice, maybe?
You don't know? You blacked
ice.
Out?
There was ice. You fatted out. There was ice. Your Honor, I fatted out. I don't recall. There was ice. I think the person applied ice, and you laid it.
To his brow?
To was his he brow. Like,
oh,
true.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Lemaire, quick question. I mean, we'll get off the...
Look at your pride right now. I see your pride.
I don't have any pride.
Admit your attack.
I was being a cool guy.
And you're being Mr. Cool?
I was being Mr. Cool.
How cool?
I was at the punchline before.
Oh, that's
being
Mr.
Cool.
Mr. Cool
with Andy and Nate, and I had like 3 or 4 scotch and sodas. And I
you can't drink. Do you drink?
I drink a little bit.
I feel like I've never drank with you.
No, we have to.
Now he drinks. Well, he's a mogul.
True. Now these bullying white executives.
So you had a couple of scotch and sodas.
I had a couple of scotch and sodas. Then I go to the roast battle, very nervous, get upstairs.
What
somehow.
Are you nervous about?
Because I didn't think I'd get in. And then you get...
Oh, because it was full capacity and they said don't come.
Yeah, more welcome.
We can't let you in.
Yeah, but what else am I going to do? Just wait.
That's a Mr. Cool move. I know what you did. You big-timed everybody there. You
I
said,
didn't big-time.
You know me.
More scotch and sodas. You barged
I'm Matt
in.
And Shane's producer. You
I,
know
nah, I didn't say nothing. I didn't say anything.
So you ran to your car and grabbed a knife.
True.
I followed Andy. Nate
and Matt's wife was there to stop you.
Andy was on a roast battle, so I followed them in.
Gotcha.
Andy was on it, so I came with him. And then they had this drink in the back that was like wine and I don't know. It was I drank
jungle
a bunch.
Juice?
I drank a bunch. Sangria. It was jungle juice. I think it was jungle juice. I drank a bunch.
Sangria brings me back to Madrid. I'm going back to Madrid, dude. I'm getting some sangria. little fall. You get to walk through the streets and the marketplaces. They just ladle you some fucking.
You gotta go, dude.
Sangria.
You gotta go back.
I said, damn it, damn it.
You're back like a full like old school country, like a little.
I'm going
Paris.
Full I'm going back MAGA, dude. I'm going full MAGA.
Probably get respect over there.
The fascistas.
Fascistas, dude.
The fascistas will be like,
fuck yeah, dude.
Dude, get this guy in here.
So Lemaire, so you go in there, you shoulder to the punch bowl.
Yeah.
You came
elbow
in
your way to the punch
shit-faced.
Bowl.
I came in drunk and I started power drinking, and then I the show was over and I was like, I gotta go on the stairs. I'm sweating and I threw up and I went to sit down, and then Kyle
you threw up.
Ew,
you
show,
threw a punch.
I threw up. It was like a lot. It was like,
yeah, but you threw up the. Oh, there was food in there.
Yeah, there was food in there.
Jesus. What were you grubbing on beforehand?
I don't know.
Yeah, you do. What were you grubbing on?
It was
probably Chipotle.
Oh, Chipotle and
Scotch and jungle juice in a fucking hot stairwell. That's like a pressure cooker, dude. That's
yeah,
like a
dude.
They put that. That's like what those.
That's
kids,
a bomb.
That's yeah. That's Boston Marathon. They just put Chipotle and Scotch in a Lemaire, set him on the sidewalk, and he exploded.
So you hit the steps. You puke.
After I puke, I hit the steps. I was on the steps because I was waiting for the bathroom to open up and waiting for nobody to be there so I can go puke. But then I was discovered.
Good friend Kyla Fox friend. Discovers you.
Yeah, a lady found him. Yeah. Oh, my God. Yay, what are you doing in here? Oh, my God, are you suffering from a fat attack on the steps? No, it was Chipotle. That's a fat attack, dude. Don't try to blame fucking pre-existing conditions on this.
That's true. That's like a COVID test.
Yeah,
you have
a COVID
pneumonia
test.
And you have a little bit of COVID. So,
but yeah, legally I can do whatever I want, drenched.
Yeah, or just hang around port cities.
Oh, can you tell me how dry my clothes should be? At what point are you allowed into a store on how wet you are?
I think you'd be fully soaked.
I think you might be right.
Dude, if you went fully soaked, you would stay.
I wonder if there is a line. Like, yeah. Be like, all right, what if I was a little dry?
Like, they're going to get, like, a hygrometer and, like, measure
yeah.
how fucking, how, like, how moist you are.
Yeah.
I think if you have, like, 100% humidity level, they'll be like, dude.
You're not allowed in.
I think when they scan your forehead, they also touch your clothes, and they're like, how wet is this
soaked. Yeah, it's weird, but we keep having customers come in drenched. I'm sorry about this. Sorry about this inconvenience. Take your jacket off. Are you hiding that you're drenched? Take it off, you're just drenched. Yeah.
You're like, now he walks, he's like that little trail of drips. All yeah. like, God damn it, get him out.
These guys think it's funny, they keep coming to my damn restaurant soaked.
This isn't a goddamn snack bar with Six Flags, dude.
That's a funny way to torture a local restaurant, just keep randomly sending people in soaked. What the hell's going on? This is the third guy this week. Something's going on. These guys are drenched.
It's pretty funny, too, to show up and be like a black couple just drenched. And he's like, are you guys fucking serious? You're like,
yeah. Well, you can say, you know.
Oh, my God, dude. Stop, I'm telling you, dude, we should go out to water. We should go out to a restaurant drenched and just see what happens.
It would be like, you can't come in. They would call the police. You can't be drenched, dude.
That's fucked up, dude.
You can't
not
be leaning,
everyone can afford to be dry all the time.
You can't
dude.
Be leaning drenched them, dude.
We have to get drenched, dude.
I would get drenched and go to fucking Fogo de Chao. Fogo de Chao, just get a table of drenched dudes. Like 12 drenched dudes.
You have to wear suits. That's the only other thing.
You have to wear.
You have to be
yes.
dressed so nice, but just drenched.
And you'd be like, excuse me, can I have a pitcher of water, please? No ice. Just fucking... I like it.